About in. All over the shop. Calamity upon calamity in the West Indies camp.
Bowled him. What a beauty. Swinging back in at Griffiths. It was the first ball he faced, and it was a snorter from Goff.
Late in swing. That's what's done the damage. Full-length delivery, but if we watch it on the replay, it swings back at Griffith very late, committing him to an off-drive. First ball he faces. Going for a big drive, and it's swinging back through the gate. It's a great start for England. It's a great start for Goff. Three for one.
First ball, Wavell Hines is out. 88 miles an hour, swinging back in. England on fire. Successive deliveries from Goff. And Hines follows Griffiths back to the shower.
Well, I can tell everyone, Headingley has absolutely erupted. Darren Goff. Yorkshireman doing the business for England. He's taken the first two wickets, and this is absolutely plumb. The ball once again swinging back at the left-hander. Trapping him dead in front. That's hit the back pad. That's rocking middle stump. Well, there's another West Indian batsman who really hasn't troubled the scorers at all. It's three for two.
Darren Goff, of course, already has a test hat-trick to his name. But wouldn't this be special? One of the world's greatest batsmen on strike, Brian Lara, he has really taken his time. And now Nasser Hussain, just playing a few mind games with Lara. Swapping the field round. And look at all those close catches.
Brian Lara, he had to be on top of his game from the first delivery. It was very similar to the previous two deliveries. And Lara, that just jamming down on at the last moment. This ball is hooping around.
And that's that line, and that's that finger. Doug Cowie has raised it twice. Lara's gone, Goff's on fire, and Headingley rise.
Well, I can't believe it. Same dismissal twice in the one test match, and it's Brian Lara as well. You would have thought he'd make the same mistake again. Pitches in the red zone, no shot offered. Wow. Off stump would have been out of the ground if his paddock wasn't in the way. No problem with that, LB. Darren Goff, three wickets. Brian Lara, only two runs. 11 for three, and the West Indies are in all sorts of trouble now.
Craig White on the left of your screen. Umpire George Sharp was officiating that LBW decision. Doug Cowie had the pleasure of raising his finger when Darren Goff was the bowler. Sharp with the left hand, Cowie with the right hand.
He deserves the smile. Didn't matter whether he was Malcolm Marshall or Dennis Lilly, the great bowlers, the great swing bowlers of the era. He had matched them with this performance. And at the other end, Andrew Caddick, with bounce and movement, was giving him outstanding support. Top class. Graham Hick, the catcher, he's had a big day, though not as big as the one that Darren Goff is having. Sherwin Campbell, the man who's back to the pavilion now. The West Indies in total disarray.
What a delivery this was. Great leg cutter, bounce and movement. And a very smart catch by Graham Hick. He would have been unsighted by Graham Thorpe's left hand coming across his vision. But he held on to it well. The big man has a safe pair of hands. Sherwin Campbell, though, departs for 12, 21 for 4.
And a very happy Yorkshireman who left the field at tee with figures of 4 for 12. At this stage, the West Indies 23 for 4. There was mayhem at Headingley. A huge crowd was involved. There was a threat of rain. Indeed, a few West Indians were praying for it. Ramnaresh Sarwan, the one real class act so far. He was unbeaten in the first innings with 59. He'd had a little bit of a going over from Jimmy Adams when he played one stroke that was too expansive. But it really was a case of digging in here. It must have felt such a helpless task for both Adams and Sarwan.
The footwork wasn't right. Jimmy Adams wasn't getting his front foot across to the ball. There was still movement. Caddick had bowled splendidly, was keeping it tight.
And if the footwork wasn't right, nor were the fingers either, because the extra bounce that the England bowlers were getting out of the pitch were causing problems. This took a long time for Adams to get bandaged up after it. Real pain there and real pressure too.
Well, he's done the same after that long break. He has done exactly the same thing as in the first innings. He's dragged the ball back onto his stumps. Well, that was a bit of an airy-fairy shot. I think we can hazard a guess that his concentration wasn't what it should have been. He may have been in quite a bit of pain as well. And he's dragged it back on and five down for 49.
Always giving it out. Goodness me. For me, there's enough doubt, I think, for the umpire to be able to say not out. He's done all the right things. It has hit him between wicket and wicket. And whether it will go on as it's come back at him a bit to miss leg stump, or whether it's a touch high, that's another consideration.
Ridley Jacobs has gone for 152 for 6.
Oh, bowled in! All over the shop. Calamity upon calamity in the West Indies camp. English cricket is alive and kicking here in Leeds. Oh, bowled in too! This is brilliant. This is quite fabulous bowling and quite mesmeric cricket all round. The whole of Headingley is on its feet.
Look at this field. Have you ever seen anything like it? Every single England fielder is in an attacking position. Five slips, two gullies, a short leg, a backward short leg. Oh, play and miss. You wouldn't write the script, you wouldn't put it in a comic book.
All four wickets in the over to Andy Caddick. Full length delivery coming in to Ridley Jacobs. Another full length delivery getting rid of Nixon McLean. Importantly, another full length delivery, Kirtley Ambrose this time. And again, full length disturbing the off stump of Rion King.
It is all over. Andrew Caddick, five wickets. Darren Goff, who started it all, four wickets. England have won this match within 2 days. One of the more extraordinary test matches you will ever see. The margin, an innings and 39 runs.